This is part 4 of a series on random forest. In the previous video, we looked at the out-of-bag score. In this video, we will look at how to handle missing values in dataset. Let's take a look at the proximity matrix and how to use it to handle missing values in the training and test data. If your data has missing values, you can use random forest to estimate the missing values. A proximity matrix is used for that purpose. First, let's look at the simple data below. There are 4 data points in total. 4 features X and 1 target class Y. These values are missing in the 4th data point. Our goal is to estimate these missing values using the proximity matrix of random forest. This is the data that is used in the reference video below. This is a very good video. The basic idea is to estimate the missing values of a data point by referencing data points that are similar to that data point. Data point 4 is very similar to data point 3. The two features are exactly the same, and the target class is the same. If so, these missing values are likely to be similar to these values. Data points 4 and 1 are not similar. Therefore, these missing values will not be similar to these values. This is the basic idea of estimating missing values. The proximity matrix is used to measure the similarity between data points. And since similarity is the inverse of distance, 1 minus the proximity matrix is the distance matrix. Now let's take a look at the procedure for creating the proximity matrix. First, set the initial values for the missing values. For categorical data, the most frequent value is used as the initial value. The target class of the data point 4 is no. Therefore, the initial value is set to no, which is the most frequent category value among the data points whose target class is no. For continuous numeric data, set the initial value to the median or average value. Similarly, the median or average is also calculated for the values of data points where the target class is no. Since data point 4 has a target class of no, we only use data points where Y is no. Now that we have no missing values, we can use this data to train a random forest model. Let's say the model has 10 trees. Now run this data down the 10 trees that has been trained. If tree 1 looks like this, let's say the first data point belongs to leaf node number 3. And let's say the second data point belongs to leaf node 0. In this way, find the leaf node numbers to which each data point belongs. You can use the Python code below. You can easily find leaf node numbers by using the model's apply function. This table shows that in tree 1, data points 3 and 4 belong to the same leaf node. And in tree 2, data points 2, 3, and 4 belong to the same leaf node. This means that data points belonging to the same leaf node are similar to each other. Now we use this table to create a proximity matrix. For tree 1, it shows that the pair of data points 3 and 4 belong to the same leaf node. and the pair of data points 4 and 3 belong to the same leaf. The code below makes it easy to create this table. You can easily create this table by using numpy's equal outer function for this column vector in tree 1. And all diagonal elements are set to 0. For tree 2, since these three pieces of data are in the same leaf node, the table looks like this. For tree 3, these two data points belong to the same leaf node. This is identical to the table for tree 1. Now we sum all the tables element by element. Then you can get a table like this. Data points 3 and 4 are on the same leaf node in all three trees. Therefore, the data points 3 and 4 are very similar each other. Now let's say that adding up all 10 trees gives us the following table. Data points 3 and 4 belong to the same leaf node in 8 trees. And we normalize this table. You can normalize it by simply dividing it by the number of trees. Or you can normalize it so that the sum of the values in each column is 1. Here we use the latter method for normalization. This is the proximity matrix obtained in one iteration. Now we need to repeat this process a couple of times. Now that we learned about the proximity matrix, we can use it to estimate missing values in the training data. The proximity matrix obtained from the first iteration on the previous page is like this. And the initial estimate of the missing values are like this. First, let's estimate the missing value for the numeric feature, weight. The weight feature vector is like this. And the proximity matrix is like this. Let's multiply the vector and the matrix. Because we are estimating the missing values of the data point 4, we can use only column 4 vector in the proximity matrix. The result of multiplying them together is like this. These values are not used. This is the new estimate. We then update the initial value to the new estimate of 198.5. We then retrain the random forest using the updated data and create a new proximity matrix. And we update this value again with the new proximity matrix and retrain the model with this data to create another new proximity matrix and update it again. Continue repeating this process until the estimates no longer change. Data point 4 has high similarity to data point 3, which is why data point 3 is given higher weight. So this is a weighted average method. Less weight is applied to dissimilar data point. This is how to estimate the continuous numerical data. Next, let's look at how to estimate categorical variables. Let's look at the rest of the data points except data point 4. There are 2, no, s and 1, yes. So there is a 1/3 chance that this feature is yes, and a 2/3 chance that it is no. Multiply this probability by this weight from the proximity matrix. Yes is for data point number 2, so the numerator is 0.1. And the denominator is the sum of the weights. In this way, the probability is multiplied by the weight. This result is 0.033. The probability that the category is no is 2/3. And since data points 1 and 3 are no, their weights are also 0.1 and 0.8. So this result is 0.6. Since 0.6 is greater, this missing value is assumed to be no. The denominator is always 1 because we normalized the proximity matrix. This process is also repeated until the estimate does not change. This time, let's estimate the missing values in the test data. There are 4 training data points and 1 test data point. And there is 1 missing value in the test data. Let's assume that the missing values in the training data have already been estimated in this way, through the process on the previous page. Therefore, there are currently no missing values in the training data. We want to set the initial value for the missing value in the test data. However, there is no target class Y in the test data. In this case, we use all the training data points and set the initial estimate to the average of these values and run this test data down the trees that are already trained. We can get the leaf node numbers of each tree for this test data point. Now use this table to create the proximity matrix in the same way as on the previous page. We use the training and test data together to create the proximity matrix. Let's assume that the normalized proximity matrix is like this. Now we use this proximity matrix to estimate the missing value in the same way as on the previous page. The detailed procedure for this will be written in code in the next video. This time, let's estimate the categorical variables. The value of this feature is missing from the test data. This example comes from the Stat Quest video above. Since there are no target values in the test data, we consider all cases of the target class. Replicate this test data point by the number of target classes, making them 2. This is what is mentioned in the reference 2. If there are no labels, the test set is replicated as many times as n class. Each replicated data point then has a target class. So we can estimate this value in the same way that we estimated the training data on the previous page. Let's say the initial estimate was no, but has now been updated to yes. And let's say the second replicated data point is just estimated to be no. Now run each data point down the trees. Let's say that there are 5 trees in this model. Let's say tree 1 estimates this to be yes. Tree 2 also estimates it to be yes, and tree 3 estimates it to be no, and so on. Then 3 out of 5 are yes. And let's say the estimates for the second data point are like this. Only tree 3 estimates this as no. So the no percentage is 1 in 5. The missing value in this test data is then estimated to be, yes, because this value is larger. This augmented test set is run down the trees. In each of replicates, the one receiving the most votes determines the class of the original case. So far, we've looked at how to estimate missing values in training and test data using the proximity matrix. In the next video, we'll write code to estimate the missing values using the proximity matrix.